Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. I am the spiritual artist, and today I'm going to give you a little bit of a demonology video. The demons I speak about today are called Incubi and Succubi. Incubi meaning a male sex demon, succubus meaning a female sex demon. Incubi comes from the Latin word incubo, which means nightmare, and please believe to get rid of these entities is a complete nightmare. They're really hard to get rid of. They're shapeshifters. They're demons that take human form. They're a type of energy vampire that's sexual in nature. They will drain you. They drain you through sex. If you've ever slept with somebody that you feel like you just couldn't shake, they just really put you in a trance with the sex. You just can't get enough. You find yourself lost and turned out. You feel like you're, you know, in a trance, controlled. Getting dreams. A lot of times if you Google Incubi, you'll find little demons sitting on top of people or sitting under people while these people lie asleep. And that's because these energies do like to catch you in vulnerable states. A lot of times in rest, but a lot of times when you're just in a vulnerable state in your life, they definitely like to go after people who are righteous or religious, nuns, priests, just your average, you know, generally good person. And Incubi or Succubi will find you as a target. They want to turn you out. They want to destroy you. They want to eat you. You're a fresh soul or a good soul. That if you look at the movie Bram Stoker's Dracula, there's a scene where when Winona Ryder or Wilhelmina's fiance, he went to Dracula's home. There, it's a bunch of like, looks like female vampires that are, they have like several heads, and they come out of this bed and they like sleep with Keanu Reeves, and they're just trying to have like this big orgy with him. And those are a good example. That scene is a good example of succubi. Women just, you know, with this thirst for sex, and very attractive women, you know, even the men, very attractive, well endowed. If they're a man working with something below the waist, if they're a woman, nice body, pretty face, says all the right things, you know, the sex is just so good, it rocks your world, and you start having dreams. It's just opening Pandora's box. When you get with this person, it's like the devil card. It becomes a really nasty bond that keeps you guys together. You can walk away, but you find it difficult to. You walk away, and, if, you know, soul ties are real. Nothing good can come from it. They don't mean you any well. I'm just going to give you some tarot card ideas that are going to show you how this can get nasty. There's the Lover's card in the deck, and the Lover's card is when things are going pretty smoothly. That's how it should be if you guys are both pure souls who are coming together for, you know, true love. You really love each other. You're really interested in one another. The dark side of the Lover's card is the Devil card. They both represent choices. But notice how on the Devil card, it's like this entity in the middle that is holding them together. It's something really nasty holding them together. And that means you're dealing with something. It's not just you and that person. There's something in this person that you are with that has another type of energy that is holding you together. It's not human. And it doesn't, again, it doesn't mean any well. You can walk away, but it's going to take work. It takes you wanting to release the chains. In the Devil card, the people are chained up, they're bound by something. They can walk away because the chains are loose, but they have to want to walk away. And that's where things get tricky, because some people, and I'll talk more about this in another video, some people are addicted to self-sabotage, are addicted to things that don't do them good, are addicted to just complete foolery. And that's just the truth, guys. And you have to just identify if you're that kind of person. However, with the Devil card, you can walk away. It's just going to take a little bit of work. And I find that that work tends to be cord cutting spell work, which I have a video on already. Please take a look at that. And if you have any more questions, please send me a DM through Instagram. With Incubi and Succubi, the only thing that can come of that is the Tower card. Whether you willingly cut them off and leave them alone, or whether the universe has to twist your arm and force you. The Tower card is complete destruction. I think I talked about that a little bit on my last video about my spiritual journey. The Tower card is just a mess. And it will happen because you have to get rid of this person, and when you do get rid of them, it won't be peaceful. This person wants to feed off of you. Being around this negative energy for too long can lead to death. You are their victim. They are feeding off of you through sex. It's just like if you were with the actual vampire that was, you know, biting your neck every day and draining your blood. It is just that serious. So eventually, you can't take anymore. And it could be a slow process or it could be a quick process. But nothing but, again, complete hell and turmoil will ensue with staying with this energy. To get rid of this energy, I recommend release spells. I recommend just deciding to really be delicate in your heart and in your soul. Stop fucking with this person. Realize that if you want to do better, it's not going to work with this energy around you. And again, if you need help doing any cord cutting spell work, release work, I'm happy to help you guys. My rate is $50 an hour. If you want a personal reading, please let me know. Tell me down below your experiences with this kind of energy, and I look forward to seeing you guys in the next video. Thank you so much. Enjoy the rest of your day, and be very safe of sexually transmitted demons.